If you're familiar with our channel, then you know I spent last week mounting two 100-watt Renogy solar panels onto our roof. Andrew handled the additional wiring, and they have been working great all week. In continuation of that solar panel project, we are adding an additional MPPT charge controller to our system. We already own the smart solar MPPT charge controller from the Dreamboat project, so we decided we should take advantage and install it on our own rig.
When we got lithium batteries, we relocated the batteries back here to the dinette bench, and we've installed the MPPTs right next to them on the front wall of the dinette bench. So wiring up this new MPPT charge controller wasn't very difficult because we had wiring for the old one. One set of wires came from the panels on the roof, and one set of wires came from the ZAMP jack up at the front of the trailer. So all I really had to do was separate the wires, each set to each charge controller. Real quick, since I have this apart, I'm testing the battery voltages to make sure they're about equal. So I'm seeing 13.35 on the left one, and over here on the right one, I've got 13.35. That's perfect.
The reason we have a second MPPT charge controller is because of the Dreamboat project. And the reason that we're going to install it here in this Airstream is to future-proof our solar system. With the two separate charge controllers, I can deploy 400 watts on the ground, and currently 200 watts on the roof is expandable to up to 600 to 800. So what this does is give us options. So let me show you my ground deployable setup. So we bought this Jackery Explorer 1500 solar generator before we actually purchased this Airstream trailer. Now, this solar generator has proprietary input connectors for the solar panels. And Shauna did a bunch of digging around to try to figure out how to get us a harness that will allow us to connect the panels to the Airstream. This added utility definitely made this much more useful for us. To connect our four Jackery panels to our trailer, it takes three connectors. This is the first one. It's a ZAMP connection on one end and standard solar on the other. The second connector is a Bouge RV 4-to-1 branch connector, so that takes one solar connection and splits to four. We take the trailer side connect here, and we've got four connections, positive and negative on this end. The last piece of this harness is a female 8mm to solar connection, and we had to buy four of them, one for each Jackery Solar Saga panel. Now, the most important thing to know about this piece is that on the female end, you need to shave back the plastic housing so that the male side on the Jackery, whether it's a proprietary modification of theirs or what, this doesn't seat until you trim the edge back a little bit. Shauna had me do that with just a basic razor blade. It wasn't very difficult at all. So just to recap, we've got three different cables. We've got our ZAMP to solar, we've got our 4-in-1 combiners, two of them, and then our four female 8mm to solar connections on this end. All right, let's go test the new MPPT charge controller. I'm gonna go to our ZAMP connection up in the front. I do wanna say that I'm gonna at some point add a second ZAMP connector in the back of the trailer, so I've got options. But for right now, we're gonna go test that new MPPT charge controller with our solar panels. All right, one panel at a time. These are our proprietary Jackery ends into the trimmed female ends. The second MPPT is working great, and the installation of it allows us to future-proof our Airstream so that we can get ground-deployed solar when we need it, but also expand our roof mounted solar as time and money permit. As disappointed as Shauna is that we're not installing these parts on Dreamboat right now, I think we're making the best of it by installing them on our actual home.
Yeah, well, don't do what I just did. So to safely work on installing the MPPT, I disconnected the batteries. I was very proud to see that my batteries had exactly the same voltage when I tested across them.
Not anymore.
Well, we'll get to that in a second. See, our whole system shut down because we didn't have enough power, which seemed weird to me. I turned the generator back on, company provided generator, and the house current, the 120, came right back. We did not get 12 volt power back, which means something is wrong. So I open this up and I look at it and I don't see anything amiss. And I go get the electrical tester and I see voltages that are weird.
and I realize I got that problem.
The headlamp's cracking me up, buddy.
Give me serious face.
I can't. This is my serious face.
This is serious business.
I know.
So, to keep this safe out of the way from shorting on something while I was working, I tucked it beside the batteries here, and I couldn't see it when I went to reconnect. So, long story short,
you forgot to connect it.
Yes, we've unevenly charged our batteries, and this power system really connected like that is not safe. Essentially, it's like a bus bar here. This battery's not connected to power. Big problem. I am now going to disconnect again both batteries and figure out what the actual voltages are. We're going to have to charge one battery by itself back up to the voltage of the other before I can reconnect them.
Well, we didn't burn anything down, so.
First battery is the battery basically hasn't changed voltage since it was left disconnected. The other battery that has been connected, 12.14. That must have dropped below shutdown voltage. That's why that's so low.
Well, the electric kettle has been...
Yeah, we were running electric kettle, all kinds of stuff today. The fridge has been running off this.
I can't even with the headlamp, Andrew. It's like, I'm dying. It's so funny.
I'm doing important work here.
Yeah, it's true. You are, but it's actually getting on to be your bedtime.
When I think about springtime, think about spring flowers, think about increasing temperatures, all the animals that come out with the increasing temperatures, and think about spring cleaning, all the necessary repairs that go along with that. But spring's also about change. And one of the things that we've been thinking about is change. With the increasing temperatures here in South Texas, we're thinking we may not want to be here for the summer. And more on all that in this video.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I've got some more camping updates, if you're ready. So I've contacted a couple places. One place so far has gotten back to me in California. And the good news is it's very close to the ocean, but it's only part-time paid work in addition to the free campsite.
Oh, that won't work with our current financial goals.
There's potential in some other ones, but we need to kind of keep working to find a better situation.
Basically, you're finding opportunities?
I am. Right. I am searching kind of broadly. These are all kind of summer positions around 4 to 5 months.
Mm. Okay.
So.
That's promising. One of the problems with gate guarding, for those who don't know, so Andrew's been up, it's like midday for him. And so his pace, his mental like rev, is his RPM is higher than mine, where I've just crawled my butt out of bed. And it's the same for him at 3 in the morning. When I'm like, here's all the news of what happened last night, gotta go to bed, you know, and he's like, oh.
I've taken the time to reattach the compressor into the bed of the truck. We've been driving back and forth on these really rough gravel roads, and it's just hard on everything. And at some point, the compressor vibrated loose. Now I'm gonna power it up and blow all the dust out of the truck.
Just been woken up. I don't know what day it is or where I am. There was a mouse running around in broad daylight, and someone is
so embarrassing. I'm like jumped up on the dinette just screaming uselessly because I was scared and startled by the mouse. So now there's traps with peanut butter all underneath the couch and wherever we think it might have come in. We'll put more traps out tomorrow, but it's not my it's not my best moment. So embarrassed.
Did you see that? Shauna. Hey Shauna, there's a roadrunner on the back of the truck.
I've checked the traps. You know, put traps underneath the couch. 3 of them. There's really no sign that anything's been near them. I'm starting to check the external compartments, and I'm just not seeing any sign that we've got mice really living in the trailer. I think we just had an Explorer.
If you start to look around your Airstream, there's a lot of places that aren't perfectly sealed, such as right here. We've got a place where a mouse could easily get in.
Another one of the potential ingress points that's always concerned me is right here, where the main wiring goes up through the floor into the Airstream.
Now we're up here under the couch, and what I've done is stuff aluminum foil into there, hopefully to limit anybody's ability to climb up and chew their way through that hole.
I've also emptied everything out of here, and I just don't see any signs that the mice are living in here. Now there's plenty of pathways where they can run around from compartment to compartment, but I don't think they're really making a nest in here. There's no sign of it. While I was looking around for evidence of mice, I found some trouble here. This is our city water inlet, which generally speaking, we don't use.
I believe the water's leaking through the seam between the two halves of the white plastic. If I remember correctly, I've tightened the four screws before to try to get it to stop leaking. Now, since we're not connected to city water, the pressure in that water line is coming from the pump, which is pressurizing all the water lines in the trailer, up to, I think it's a backflow preventer and check valve.
Just gonna take a slight turn on it, see if that helps.
All of these screws have turned kind of an easy quarter turn. Here's the exterior of the trailer with the water inlet, and you know, we've replaced it. This one that's leaking is a new one. It's over a year old, but rarely used. Everything's all sealed correctly. The water is definitely coming from the inside of it. And again, it's not connected to any pressure. All the pressure is coming from the inside of the trailer and leaking out. Leave a comment if you know of a different version of this, maybe even a quick connect style. Again, this one's nearly new, minimally used, and it's definitely leaking. And if there's an improved design that we should know about, please let us know in the comments. Then there's the tank flush valve. That's a whole separate video. No idea why that's physically above the fresh water inlet. So if any drippage comes out of here, I don't know. I don't understand that, but that's how Airstream made it.
Looks like we've got a little bit of an unpredicted rainstorm. Hoping it only lasts a few minutes. It'll keep the dust down, so that's cool.
You can do that for hours. Just hours. Mockingbird goes through everything he knows.
Are you all set? I'm about to head to the post office.
Yep.
Okay. Your hair is voluminous today.
I haven't seen it because, I mean, who cares, right? Like.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
But I'm pretty sure my hair is voluminous every day. This is just.
Yep. Yeah. It's up.
It'll be more down after the hat. Don't have fun without me, Andrew.
I wouldn't dream of it. Off to the muddy road.
There are old ones that are filled with dirt and stuff, but there are definitely new dimples. It's not enough for us to make an insurance claim, but it doesn't feel very good. I don't know. I'm happy that it's not any worse than it is.
Sport camping update. So far, I have contacted about 10 places, either phone or email. I really just cold called some places that I searched up on Google. I haven't found the right situation for us yet. Spoke with someone today and they had a full hookups, but they only had 20 hours a week per person.
And we absolutely need full time for the both of us.
Yeah, there seems to be a lot that fall into that vague category.
Well, and the other thing is that we are looking for something either at elevation,
yep,
or something that's cooler than 110 degrees, so maybe in the northern part of the country. But I don't want to take a massive pay cut, Andrew, just to avoid the temperature.
I think they're out there. I think we just have to kind of stay strong and hold out.
Yeah,
and we'll find something.
I also think it's easier for us because we know we can just stay on the gates.
Yeah, that's the fallback, right?
Yeah.
I think what I'm happy with so far is that I wasn't afraid to tell people we need full-time work, and they were pretty happy to either say, well, we don't have that, or alternatively, a couple of them have kind of got me the particulars on what they do have and what it would pay. And really, we can't take
a pay cut.
No, I mean, slight.
Slight,
but I'm optimistic. I think there will be something out there.
A couple days ago, it was 90, super warm, it was glorious. Then we had rain and hail, and I'm so glad our trailer isn't damaged, but it's actually 40 degrees colder right now. It's like in the 50s, and that feels abrupt. It does. I'm cold. That's why we're wearing winter hats and like base layers. We've turned into babies.
So I remove these batteries and charge them separately up to
matched voltages, reconnected them, and hopefully now the Victron can take over to keep them charged and balanced, and hopefully haven't done any lasting damage.
Well, that was fun. Just noticed a cow that had escaped from the pasture back here and basically was out grazing over here on the other side of the fence. Now, the problem with that is this road straight behind me now is fairly busy. It's Sunday morning, so the traffic is light, but normally most days this is pretty busy, which they're, I believe, trying to keep the cows separate. And so when he heard me step over here, his head poked up and he knew he was up to something, ran, sprinted, and jumped back over the cattle guard, the one right back here, jumped over it like it wasn't even there and got back into the pasture he was supposed to be in. I haven't had to call anybody or anything and just kind of tell them like there may be an issue,